A South Florida mother and her three small children are being kicked to the curb because she says, well, she didn't provide an ultrasound image to her landlord while she was pregnant.
And tonight, fair housing advocates and attorneys are calling the practice outrageous, and they've filed suit. Why would a landlord need a picture of the inside of her body?
Local 10 investigator Jeff Weinseer went to find out.
I'm about to get kicked out of my apartment where I'm going to go. I think about that every day.
She is a single mother of three. She works full time, but these days it's hard to concentrate when you're about to be thrown out.
You know, every day I'm going looking for apartments. I can't focus on my job, can't focus on my children.
Taisha Davis calls Sorrento of Miramar home. This is privately owned affordable housing built in part with your tax dollars. Because of a massive affordable housing shortage, it took Davis almost a year to get into Sorrento. She's never been late with the rent. There are no complaints against her, but according to this letter, her lease isn't being renewed. You see, shortly after she moved in, Davis says she got a call from assistant property manager Jose Galindo.
He said, we're not going to renew your lease. And I said, why? He said, because of your pregnancy. And I said, oh, what can I do?
Davis says she was told she didn't comply with an apparent policy for pregnant women.
He told me you had to give him an ultrasound and a letter from the doctor stating my due date.
A picture of your stomach and a letter from the doctor. Did they ever ask for one?
They never asked for one.
Our messages weren't returned, so we showed up at Sorrento's rental office.
Sir, I'm wondering if I could ask you about asking people for ultrasound pictures, sir. Are you a doctor? What do you guys do with those pictures, sir?
To ask for a photograph of the inside of a mother's womb is so intrusive, invasive, and it has absolutely no business reason for being in an application to rent.
Kenya Robertson is president and CEO of Housing Opportunities Project for Excellence, or HOPE. It's a nonprofit, and one of HOPE's missions is investigating housing discrimination.
Our tester posed as a pregnant housing seeker.
HOPE Incorporated sent a young woman undercover into Sorrento's office.
They, being our tester, were told that an ultrasound and letter certifying pregnancy and giving a date that the child was due was a requirement.
In fact, a rental agent at Sorrento even wrote it on a list of requirements that was given to the undercover tester.
Because they're essentially non-renewing her lease because of the fact that she didn't tell them about a pregnancy is the reason why we're suing them.
Attorney Matthew Dietz says this isn't just about Taisha Davis.
How many people were evicted? How many people didn't get apartments? How many people have they hurt before?
This law that prohibits discrimination against families with children has been in effect for 30 years. If you're going to be in the business, you need to know the rules.
Local 10 News contacted all of the companies listed in this lawsuit. We have not gotten a single call back.
What do you guys do with those pictures, sir?
I just hope we can get this fixed.
You're denying housing to those people who this housing was intended to benefit. You're not doing what it is you said you'd do when you took our tax dollars to make this housing available.
In Miramar, Jeff Weinseer, Local 10 News.
Okay, Jeff, thanks a lot. Local 10 News has reached out to HUD, the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development, to get their reaction. We are waiting for a response tonight. And Broward County also gave tax dollars to this project. The director of housing says that since a lawsuit has already been filed, they will monitor the situation.